Good evening. We have 209 new positive cases today, and our recovery for today is 206. Active cases, therefore, are 1657, and our cumulative recoveries till date is 4211. The number of tests done today is 2412. Since my colleague Sanjay has nothing more to add, you may ask questions if any.
Less number of tests
since now? No, Sadhguruji, less number of tests,
2412.
It is not dangerous because we have told everybody that once they give their swab, they are to be in isolation. Why do you give the swab in the first place? When you have a doubt that you have come into contact with any a positive person, or perhaps in Arogya Setu you are being shown as positive, there is some reason why you are being taken swab. Or then the health officers have told you to come because you are a contact. Now, once you give your swab, naturally we expect every citizen to be responsible enough to maintain home isolation till the result comes. Now, 5 to 7 days delay, I don't accept that there is 5 to 7 days delay. Where even though we have a backlog which we have drastically reduced, the backlog is of the past 48 hours. It is not maximum, it can be 72 hours. There may be certain delays in certain cases where the results have not been triggered. The result is ready, meaning the lab has done the test, but the result SMS has not been triggered and it has not been sent to the person. Every day we are taking a review of this. We are constantly in touch with the teams which are sending the SMSs. So about this danger aspect, I do not agree, because anybody who gives their swab is strongly advised, and they themselves know that they have to be, just because you give the swab, you cannot be negative. Until you know the result, you have to be socially responsible to isolate yourself. So please do that, is my appeal to those who have given the swabs and are awaiting the results.
Ma'am, all about antigen test?
We have started it. Antigen test was started from 5 days back in the case of couple of flights. The first 2 days we did as a sort of pilot for two flights which landed at our airport. Then the third day we expanded to all the flights which were landing. So that happened for 2 days. Now from today onwards, we have started antigen testing in our district hospitals, both Hospicio and Asilo, as well as in our sub-district hospitals, Ponda and Chikale. And very soon, in the next couple of days, we will be expanding it to our PHC-CHC level also. We just got the supply of antigen tests by afternoon yesterday. Initially, we had ordered only 1,000 because we were also new to it. Then we ordered 20,000. That reached us yesterday, and that is why we have started antigen tests from yesterday onwards.
How much it cost?
Antigen? The test kit?
Yeah.
It is what? The test kit? The cost of the antigen?
Charges for the person.
Charges for the person?
Yeah.
For who is undergoing the test? Yeah. The charges remain the same. Rupees 2,000 will be the charges for any testing which has to be conducted when the person is voluntarily conducting it, you see. The travelers who are coming, they have always been paying for their tests. Whoever was paying earlier will be paying now. We are not charging anybody for antigen test as such. All, you're aware that all the samples that we do in our labs, we are not charging anybody for that, except those people who are opting for the test. You know the category of people, the travelers who are coming from outside, who are opting for the test. Apart from that, whoever we are contacting, whoever is coming because they are primary contact, etc., we have never been taking a charge from them for the test. Same applies.
What is the number of
pending imports? The samples pending are 4019. It will be part of our media bulletin also. 4019 samples pending.
There has been an incident, especially which I have come to know, like a person had given his collection on 27 June.
27 June.
June.
Mm. That, you see, these are very, very, what should I say, few and far between cases, exceptional cases. The person can get in touch with us. We'll help him find his result, or her find her result. This cannot be generalized. If at all this is true, I don't know who this person is. Because you are mentioning it to me, let the person get in touch with his PHC. The people who are expecting their results are constantly in touch with our PHC. Please don't generalize this. June 27, naturally, there is not so much pendency. It may be a sort of exception. For some reason, some technical error, his or her result may not have been communicated.
Why I am bringing it to your notice is because after the last 4 or 5 days, again that person, that's sick, so even in testing, then after that 4 days time,
If he was not communicated the result at back then, he was not positive at that time. We personally contact our health officers, personally contact each positive person. He may have given his swab. I don't know. I really find it very hard to believe that June 27th he did not get his result. So I need to get into the details of this case. If you give me the name, I can check it. But I will not say anything more than that. It is impossible that the person whose sample was given on June 27th did not know that he was positive till the last date. When he gave his sample at that time, he would have been definitely negative. For some reason, perhaps that test result was not communicated to him. He could have gotten in touch with our medical officers, health officers. We would have helped him find his result. Our health officers get daily inquiries from members of the public who have given the swab. Wherever he gave the swab, at that collection center, he could have checked.
Another earlier press conference, he also said that panch members and also have been given certain responsibility if certain person is tested positive in a village. But I have seen personal like...
What responsibility are you referring to specifically?
Like monitor.
As far as monitor.
Those who are on? Monitor? Who?
Quarantine. Mm-hmm. Isolation. Mm-hmm. The sanitizing and all. Mm-hmm. But when I spoke to that concerned person, he is saying that the government is doing a good job. The government, you follow the government protocol.
Now, I don't know which concern Panji you're talking about. It is not something which is just told in the press conference. It is duly approved on file. Responsibilities have been allotted to the local bodies, municipal authorities, panchayats. When home quarantine was what we were discussing, at that time there was an SOP approved on file, circulated. When home isolation has started, there is an SOP. Now, I will not be able to answer to individual punches comments. All that I can assure you is that SOPs are there for each and every one of these processes, which clearly define the role of each and every one of these.
Whatever you have said is totally correct. I know what you have said. But what happens when I myself have told the panchayat saying that the government has said so and so, certain SOPs have to be followed, we have to take care, or you have to also...
Who has to take care?
The panch member, I am saying.
Yes.
I said, we can work together. I said...
Yes.
He is not listening to anything. He says, the government will do. So says the...
That is probably because this particular panch is not aware of his duties. That's all that I'll comment on that. Let's move on. Yes.
Ma'am, could you give us a comment from you about the condition of Mr. Prasasi or MLA?
Sure. So the Honorable MLA, as you are aware, was shifted from our ESI hospital to GMC. He requires rehabilitation treatment for his pulmonary condition. So he is undergoing that treatment as we speak, and he is in GMC.
Was he first tested again when after he got in GMC negative?
Well, he was negative. After he tested negative, we had shifted him. There are cases where even earlier, we had many cases of positive persons first testing negative, then testing positive. This is because of the remnants of the virus which is there in the body. But that is why even ICMR changed their guidelines that patients should be discharged without the test. Because if you test them, you will definitely find remnants of the virus. It is true that when he was tested negative, that is when we shifted him from COVID hospital to GMC. And then... the repeat test which had come was positive. When the repeat test was conducted, it was positive.
And
this is also true.
These are RT-PCR tests?
Yes, RT-PCR. That's right.
Could you also specify the discharge policy for symptomatic patients from the COVID hospital? Because asymptomatic, you're already aware of.
The discharge policy is the same for asymptomatic and symptomatic, provided they don't have fever for a particular number of days, which is duly laid down. Then there is a category of critical patients, patients who are critical at some point in time. If they have been critical at some point in time, then the RT-PCR, the protocol says that the RT-PCR test should be done. One test should be done before the person can be declared cured. So we are strictly following that protocol.
Madam, now MLA will now again shifted in COVID hospital now?
No. Why so?
Again tested positive?
No, see, that is what. COVID hospital is for treating your COVID condition. The Honorable MLA, as you are aware, was there in COVID hospital for... almost a month, and he was treated. Then when his symptoms had not been there, then he was tested. He was tested negative, and that is when he shifted him from the COVID hospital to the GMC. It is not just about positive negative, it's about what type of care he requires. He requires rehabilitatory pulmonary care, which in fact is a specialized care that he requires. For his lungs, that treatment can be provided only, it cannot be provided at COVID care hospital. It has to be provided to him in a setting which is different from the COVID hospital. That is why he was shifted to GMC.
He's in isolation.
Yes, he has been kept in isolation. That's right.
Ma'am, Ma'am, just one question, not concerning this issue. I wanted to know if about a little about maybe the healthcare facilities provided to COVID patients at the facilities, at COVID care centers or
right.
at the hospitals, maybe.
Right.
Mental health facilities or support.
Yes. Are you asking specifically about mental health?
Yes.
Now, there is a very recent guideline which has been given by the ICMR to all the states. It says that we have to be equally concerned about the mental health of the persons. You see, our counselors have been there available for anybody who required special counseling. Even in our COVID hospital, initially, one of our first patients had certain issues and we had to give certain counseling. Our counselor went personally to meet him. So this is something that we have been doing routinely whenever there has been a need. Now, this guideline states that there should be certain steps taken to ensure that the mental health is also taken care of. We will abide by that. I'm sure you've seen those guidelines. That's why you're asking about this. Definitely, I've already circulated it to our COVID care in charges as well as ESI hospital.
How's the system of giving them, providing them food on time, you know, at COVID care centers, you know?
All efforts are being put in.
Because one of my friends, who is in quarantine, he said that he was not...
Quarantine?
Again, isolation.
Isolation, quarantine, COVID care?
COVID care center.
COVID care center, okay.
He was saying that he is not getting food on time,
Which COVID care center is
Farmagudi.
In Farmagudi? You see, all efforts are being put in by collectors, by their entire team of deputy collectors, mamledars, our incident commanders. Everywhere we have tied up with one or the other local caterer. I'm talking about COVID care centers to provide the food. And this is being monitored by a complete full team of the revenue administration, district administration. So all efforts are being put into place to ensure that hygienic, nutritious and timely food is being served. Now, if there is one particular issue about, you mentioned Farmagudi residency, right? We'll get it checked. Yes, I did mention about incident commanders. Over and above the collector's own team, which consists of Mamledar, deputy collector, we have incident commanders for, you would recollect that during lockdown, phase 1, 2, 3, the incident commanders were active to ensure that our supply chain was intact, to ensure that supplies are being reached out to people, medicines are going to the people who require them. Our incident commanders were very active during that time. Then in between, there was no specific task allotted to them. 2 weeks back, the incident commander system has been reactivated. And each incident commander has been asked to keep close watch over the COVID care center specifically. They have other duties as well, but one of the primary duties is to keep a close watch over COVID care center. So from multiple, I should say, people, there is a watch being maintained. But yes, there could be an odd case where there is a difficulty, there is a problem, we will definitely address it. If something of this nature comes to our notice, we'll definitely address it.
Madam, how many patients have opted for home quarantine?
You mean home isolation?
Oh, yeah.
Home isolation. Let's be very clear about the terms. Home quarantine is for those who are coming into the state, home quarantine, when they don't want to opt for the test or they are not carrying COVID negative certificate. What you're referring to is home isolation. That is a person who has been tested positive, is asymptomatic and wants to exercise the option of being at home, right? So as of now, the report that we just heard during the SEC meeting is that there have been around 190 applications. Now, very few of them, about 15 to 20 of them, are still under process. The remaining applications have been accepted. This is what the collectors have said.
I think about 24 applications have been rejected, and about
24 rejected.
Yes. Exact number will get you next time.
So the number in home isolation would be around 150.
About 150.
150, right. Any other reason
for this rejection?
Yes, the rejection decision is taken by, it is a non-recommendation. Once a person applies, the process is a person applies online. The application is parallelly going online itself to the deputy collector and to the concerned health officer. The first step is health officer should give the recommendation whether this person is fit for home isolation or not. That requires assessment of whether there are any comorbid conditions, whether the person has any pre-existing health conditions, or who are the other family members. So the health officers get in touch with the person. And then if the health officer feels that all the conditions laid down by the ministry's protocol for SOP are the SOP for home isolation are fulfilled, then the health officer recommends and then the approval is given by the deputy collector. This is the process.
Have you any, like, unless you have how this testing is done only of a particular area. Say suppose one positive case has been found in a family, and it is a family of around 20 to 25 members. Only if they have symptoms, then only they will be masked.
No, no. There is a proper contact tracing which happens. The people who are in touch with the person, now a big family of 20-25, if that entire family has been in a constant touch, in constant contact with the positive person, definitely they become primary contacts. And even amongst them, there may be elderly, there may be some pregnant women, there may be somebody with comorbid conditions. Those become high-risk contacts. So it is primary contacts, high-risk contacts, they are tested.
But they are tested?
Yes, yes, of course they are tested. Otherwise, we are definitely not saying that only symptomatic are to be tested in this category of primary contacts within the house, the family members or the people who are coming constantly in touch with the positive person within the family. Yes. I am not in a position to tell you specifically. I did hear about this. Somebody just before I came in, I received a message. I need to check. I am not sure about it. So I not want to comment on that. The number of frontline workers, health workers, you mean to say? All right. Okay.
Including
doctor,
nurses, police.
All right. Okay, so you're also talking about police then?
Police, yes.
Frontline workers.
Frontline workers. All right. I'll try to compile that figure for you and get it for you.
Any information about police officers today?
Police officers?
Police
constables. Not to my knowledge. Not to my knowledge. I don't know specifically about anybody from the police turning positive today, but it could be that I have not got to know about it and know specifically about it.
Plasma therapy may start.
Sorry?
Plasma therapy may start.
Plasma therapy, we are having the inspection by the Drug Controller General of India's team tomorrow. It's fixed for tomorrow. They will come, they will inspect our plasma therapy facility and the apheresis machine setup at GMC. So once they inspect, then their approval is very, very important. So let us hope that everything goes well and we get our approval.
How many have donated plasma so far?
Up to date figures I wouldn't have, but the last time I checked, we had around 35 to 40 people who had donated plasma. Our plasma bank is constantly getting, I should say, replenished, and the plasma is being donated. Naturally, I would appeal to all ex-positive persons who would be large-hearted enough to come forward and donate their plasma to do the same. We are also reaching out to them, but we would definitely appreciate people coming forward and expressing
their chances of them being positive again.
They are ex-positive. Yeah. There is a very stringent criteria laid down for it. A particular number of 21 days have to be there since they got cured. There are some parameters there. Yes, there is a particular criteria. If you have any comorbid conditions, if you have certain situations which are already pre-existing in your body, you cannot donate. So naturally that goes through a process of screening. Not everybody can donate plasma. We have to go through it. Even age criteria, etc. there. So definitely if somebody voluntarily comes forward, we will see, we will check everything, and then we will allow the person to donate.
In the last week, there was some confusion about this one elderly woman. I'm talking about a 92-97-year-old woman from Pedne, Pedne Taluka, that she passed away due to COVID. There were reports coming in from our local correspondents, but there's nothing reflected in the bulletin. Is there anything that we could see?
I can assure you that each and every COVID-related death, whether it has happened before they reach the hospital or otherwise, is definitely reported in our health bulletin. So if you don't find it in our health bulletin, please assume that it is not a COVID death.
And we usually went with it because the health officer concerned from there confirmed the COVID death, which is why the news reports.
I will have to check on this particular case, but every day the count is very religiously being maintained by our IDSP team. There are some cases you have seen in the past. In our media bulletin, we do mention that they reach the hospital, they die, and post-mortem, they have been found to be positive. Even those cases, every day we are including in our media bulletin. All right?
Thank you.
Sorry, before we end, I had some information to share, which I think will be of use to members of the public. The last time, I think there was a question by one of the media friends that you wanted details of the private labs which have been given permission to do testing. I'll just share it with you. So for antigen testing, we have given permission to Manipal Hospital, to Apollo Victor, their own lab, to SRL Lab in Panjim, to Lal Path Lab in Panjim, and Lab Plus, which is in Madgaon. And then I would also like to share with you that three private hospitals have reserved the 20% of their beds for COVID patients. So Manipal Hospital, Apollo Victor and SMRC. There are these three hospitals which have reserved beds. This is for public information that I'm mentioning it in the press conference. And similarly, we have two private COVID care centers, Ocean Wellness in Sangolda and Ocean Residency in Kolva. Both of these have been set up under the initiative of IMA. So these are again open to members of the public, subject to the availability of rooms there.
How do you see that they are not overcharged?
See, about the charges and the rest, we will get to it. First, let members of the public come forward to avail of the services. Then if there is any complaint, we'll look into it. This is an arrangement that IMA has made with these two facilities that I've mentioned.
You even come out with a charges table and it would be better for them to
check. No, see, we don't want to get into that right now. As I said, if there is a reason, if there is an occasion for us to take a look into it, we will look into it. Thank you.
Regarding the Mandur Hospital.
Yeah.
Which hospital?
Mandur. Issues are going with the locals. They're making the quarantine for the pregnant.
What is the issue with the locals? Are you suggesting that because the locals do not want it, we should not use it? Then probably in Madgaon or in any other place of Goa, we cannot set up anything related to COVID. So I think the answer is very obvious. We have to look at the state as a whole. We are in this together, every single citizen of the state and every single member of the government in a sense is responsible and accountable. We have to do what is best for the state.
But
thank you. Goa Medical College is also a teaching institute. Goa Medical College is a teaching institute, but we are using regularly the residents, the consultants, the doctors from GMC for treating our COVID patients. So, and by the way, let me mention to you, since this point has come up, it has been specifically mentioned by ICMR and by the ministry, I've seen correspondence myself, that all medical colleges in the country have been told to act, and they are all part of COVID management. In fact, GMC is one of the few hospitals which do not, medical colleges in the country, which do not treat COVID positive patients there. Otherwise, all medical colleges of this country, you can check if you want, are treating COVID patients within the medical college. So this logic of a teaching institute not being associated with COVID does not stand. Thank you.